Thank you, sir, for that generous introduction. Hope I'll make justice to the introduction. So I'll be speaking on the communication aspects as well as the art of holistic prescription for a postgraduate or a resident. I think the postgraduation are the best days of anybody's life. Normally, PGs look into somebody who is a successful practitioner, always envy them. But believe me, this is the best time where you have a lot of fun. And you have your best day. You can really, I mean, create a very good foundation for the edifice of your professional career. And I always say the success lies on three things: the knowledge, the exemplary, usable, contemporary, or relevant knowledge of ophthalmology that you take and keep upgrading every time, and the skills that are very important that you, I mean, imbibe during your post graduation or mentorship. And the attitude, knowledge and skills can come from the environment, can from your influences, mentors, books, other resources. But attitude is something that is inborn, something you are born with, and that is nobody can actually change it. And probably that is the very important thing for a successful practice. I think the whole idea of any kind of a residency is to create an expert from a novice. I think this continues into our lifetime. I think what is very important is the communication. I think it's always said that the good communicators get into less trouble in life, also in professional life. I think this is a communication is one area which is not in our curriculum, and somebody who's a good communicator as such probably thinks. So let us kind of see how things can go every. Like this is a PG who's just in the OPD. An unsuspecting patient walks in. And she's busy with talking to her friend, chit-chatting, and she's not even really caring what this man is all about. So she again gets distracted. The man is left in the lurch. So finally, he continues. So she has forgotten what she asked in the first place. Again, she has forgotten what she saw in the first place. So the man is making an impression of the clinician. And probably he will never visit her at the whole mahalla, the entire his, he will never recommend her to anybody. So this is just an example of how a communication can go wrong and how we can actually mess up the whole patient-doctor relationship. I think breaking the bad news is something very important. See, when you are having a case where you have to really tell some unpleasant thing, so you need to really, have some kind of empathy, put yourself in that place. Just an example of how somebody who comes with a problem. So no appropriate facial expression, no body language, which really can be appeared as compassionate. So she blurts out that she has an infection. So the patient is just snubbed into the thing. So breaking the bad news, like, there's a case of retinoblastoma needing enucleation. There could be a bilateral advanced glaucoma where the patient has already really gone blind and then you need to take care of him. Or it could be a posterior segment pathology, post-cataract. You're not really prognosticated very well, but the patient has not gained much vision, coming contrary to his expectation. And how do you actually counsel him? Or basically, let's say a child who is born with a microphthalmos or with some serious problem. How do you really counsel the parents? I think these are examples where it can really, the patients, and what is very important is an operating room. The silence is golden. I think the lesser you talk, the better it is. The people talking in very high pitch, high volume, or talking surgery, or speaking even relevant things on a mobile phone. actually makes the patient think that probably we are not doing the job in the right way. So patient probably will not pardon us for whatever could be the reason why we are talking so loudly, which is not in any way connected with the surgery. I think it's very important to keep the volume low, not to talk anything during the surgery. That is very important. At the same time, no, not to allow anything that the patient can be misconstrued. For example, if you are asking for an intraocular lens, that power is not available for some reason. And if the OT assistant say that power is not available, and the patient hears it, whatever you may do, but the patient will still go with the idea that probably something right has not been done. There were probably the lens was not available, something else would have been done. Or the kind of things that happen now. Just watch, there's a surgery training happening. So the communication happens in the local language. The patient can understand. We're not technical about it. We're not telegraphic. We are, I mean, trying to put blame games. We are
Sir, your voice is breaking. You're not audible.
The internet perhaps is not strong enough. KP sir, your video is not moving and the...
Fix the things in a way that... Okay. What about now, sir?
Better.
Yeah.
Okay. So I think the common foot in the mouth syndrome, like you speak the local language, that is the problem. You can always, you know, the avoidable conversations, you know, that is something that again is create problems and phone calls and instructions to the assisting staff and always a surgical training situations where, you know, you are sometimes in a fit of panic, you try to kind of make the patient anxious about it. At the same time, wrong jargon or using a lack of empathy, it can create problems to the patient. So I think communication skills is the cornerstone of our professional success. And it's always said that the success lies in the Broca's area. So you need to watch people. I think just like anything else, how you watch your operations in the operating room on the monitor, you also have to watch the stalwarts in their outpatient, how they counsel, how they communicate, how they make a patient understand the procedure, or how they actually, you know, solve problems or doubts. You also have to rehearse in front of the mirror. You need to kind of emulate the stalwarts or your mentors. And sometimes this is something that has a very serious thing that people have to practice. I think breaking bad news is something that's very, very important. And coming to the prescription, Dr. Guruprasad has already alluded to in some form how a prescription has to be. The aim is to communicate very clearly, no confusions allowed, legible handwriting, and instructions has to be in the local language. Many a times we write HS, BID, TD, or whatever SOS, which nobody can understand. And even you write in English for the patient who cannot read English. So it has to be in the language the patient can understand. It's also important how many bottles the patient may. Patient may be coming after 4 months. If you write one bottle, he may exhaust it and it may not be available in his place. So number of tablets, if you are prescribing a tapering dose of steroids, how many tablets are required, and any additional instruction. I think Dr. Guruprasad showed some very important reform on how a prescription has to be. And please write locally available medications. Many a time the postgraduates work in different places, in different institutions, and what is locally available, that medication, something has to be written. On sound-alike drugs, extra GAD, extra lube, can be confused, can be confusing. And always write the name, age, date, the MRD number. And you have to write your seal signature with the registration number, preferably with a seal. And any adjuvant prescription like steroids or any kind of supplements, steroids for that you need to give some anti-acidity measures. And what is very important is to teach back technique. You tell the patient, can you tell me what I have told you? Many times we come to know that how bad we have communicated. The patient hasn't understood anything. He has just nodded. So teach back is an excellent way of knowing what we have done. I think with this, This is an area where any postgraduate has to really work hard, because that builds up the confidence in their practice, and communication goes a long way, very long way, in trying to create a successful career, and they have to make a name for themselves. Thank you very much.